Hello, boys and girls of grade 6. I am teacher Melinda, and today we will do vocabulary. For vocabulary, our topic is analogies. What is an analogy? Maybe you would have heard the word or the term before in previous grades. So today, as we examine this topic, I ask the question, what is an analogy? An analogy is an expression that is used to make comparisons and show relationships between words and ideas. Analogies may be based on homes, collective nouns, group names, diminutives, songs, containers, etc. So that we have some examples. Husband is to wife, as Lord is to lady. Dog is to paw, as horse is to hoof. So there we see the relationship between the first pair, husband and wife, Lord and lady being masculine and feminine, or the second pair, dog is to paw, as horse is to hoof. In that example, we see the relationship between animals and their body parts. We also have another example. Shopkeeper is the customer, as doctor is the patient. Cow is the beef, as pig is the pork. So if I should pause a while, there we see the relationship between two occupations, shopkeeper to its customer and doctor to his patient. The second pair we have animals and their meat. So we have cow is the beef and pig is the pork. In relationships, of course, we know that we look for the common element. So we have fishmonger is the fish, as florist is the flowers. Rifle is the bullet, as bow is the arrow. Sun is the day, as moon is the night. Spider is the fly, as cat is the rat. So if we pause there, we will see the relationship between certain animals. For example, with the spider eats flies. So there is a relationship there between the animal and what it eats. And we have cat is the rat. Soldier is the army, a sailor is the navy. So in that pair, we have the collective noun that is showing the relationship between the soldier and where he works or to what group he belongs, and the sailor to the group name or the collective name, which is navy. Wrist is the arm, as ankle is the leg. So looking at the examples that were given before, as in husband is the wife, and Lord is the lady, dog is the paw, as horse is the hoof, we see relationships between one noun and another, or one type of body part to another. In this case, with dog is the paw, that's animal, and horse is the hoof, that's another animal. So boys and girls of grade 6, you may be wondering, why is it analogies are important for you at this grade? And so I'll share with you a few benefits. One, analogies show relationship between words and how they fit together, like we did in the previous examples. Dog is the paw, as horse is the hoof. So we see that relationship as it fits together between the dog and its body part being paw and horse to hoof. It also helps the learners to be creative. Analogy, when it is used, it helps the learners to look at particular areas in vocabulary, for example, like collective nouns or names, group names, and diminutives. Analogies also help learners to retain memory. So, for example, if you want to memorize some examples of collective names like group names or collective names, for example, fruit would be a group name, or vegetables, or tools, or furniture, then those group names can be retained in your memory by practicing the use of analogies, which give you that opportunity to interplay with your vocabulary skills. So analogies also help learners to make comparisons. You compare your group names as against those with body parts, or you can compare group names with collective names, or you compare diminutives with diminutives. So the benefits of analogies. It helps learners to also change their perception about a particular subject or topic. So for example, in your mind, if you're thinking that it is difficult to understand a particular topic in vocabulary, for example, collective names or group names or diminutives, then analogies will help learners to have a different mindset, because you will now have an opportunity to interplay with words and with particular topics. So there we have it. Shopkeeper is to customer, so memory work comes in there. Doctor is to patient, so you can coordinate and also associate certain names with other names or nouns with other nouns. We have rifle is to bullet, as bow is to arrow, so there is an association there, or there is a comparison where you can compare what is used with a rifle as against what is used with an arrow. So, and then we have sun is to day, as moon is to night. So it shows the difference between the heavenly bodies as it relates to the time of the day. Spider is to fly, as cat is to rat. So we see diet fitting in there of animals. Of course, we can look at the spider as being an invertebrate and the cat as a vertebrate. So there we see diet, and it helps you to compare not only the diet but also to memorize important information in relation to animals in general as you do your science lesson. So the benefits of analogies is far, it's deep, it's wide, and boys and girls, once you take it into practice and you use it not only daily but from time to time in your vocabulary, it sure will help you to retain not only the particular area of the topic, but you will also be able to make comparisons. It will also help you to be a little more creative as you write your stories, or even when you answer questions. So on your own, what is there for you to do? As grade sixers, on your own, you're asked to compile a table with analogies. Then create a jingle. Of course, we have an example. Peas is to rice as butter is to bread. So boys and girls, those of you who love music, you can have a little jingle going on in your home whilst you're there, keeping safe, observing the COVID protocols. You can enjoy using analogies by making up a jingle. So we have peas is the rice as butter is the bread, and bread is the butter as peas is the rice. And you go on and on and on. So boys and girls, I want you to truly have fun as you work with analogies. See you next time. And when we come back, I will allow you not only to have your jingle, but you can submit it to a particular email address that will be on the screen. So we can read those jingles and have a bit of music going with it. Thank you, boys and girls.